In traditional business pipelines, a lead represents a sales prospect. Basically, a business card that's been acquired but not yet qualified. In any case, it's not clear yet if this business contact represents an actual potential customer. So Salesforce keeps this separate from our existing customers and potential contacts to focus on. For nonprofits, a lead may represent an individual or organization before we are sure they will have a lasting relationship or in general have a low level of engagement, whereas a contact generally will. We can think of leads as more temporary. After a while, you will want to clear them out or give up on them. Please note, we may choose to not use leads at all, and many nonprofits do just that. Before we do, let's examine some real-world use cases. Let's say we are a service organization. We get many requests for services, yet we have a process to qualify contacts or organizations before we engage. An individual or an organization fill out an online form. Salesforce can generate these forms for free using the Web to Lead feature. This creates a lead once submitted. I can now see the lead in Salesforce. Sam Addy has applied for shelter and indicated she lives in California. Unfortunately, we only serve residents of Nevada and Colorado. In Salesforce, I mark her lead as disqualified location, and we have automation set up to send her an email listing other organizations she may contact. The lead has now disappeared from my view. The power here is that we now know how many people from other states are applying, and perhaps we can use this data to convince our board to expand our reach. A lead can be created when someone signs up for a newsletter from a specific zip code. A development person can do some research to see if they are a potential donor. Let's say Kate Whiteley has a high net worth. Let's click the convert button in Salesforce. Kate's lead can be set to automatically create a contact, a household, and an opportunity, so she is now in our pipeline of potential prospects. Similar scenarios can be applied if our organization vets, volunteers, or sells products. Remember, while leads can hold powerful potential, we will want to clearly state our business purpose and train users on them before turning on the feature. We want to ensure users do not create a lead when they should really be creating a contact, nor should they ever be confused about what our objects represent. Please check the NPSP documentation for more info and trailhead on how to set up and manage leads.